Thousands of parents are facing the prospect of removing kids from childcare when it stops being free on July 12, simply because they won't be able to afford it. Georgie Dent is the director at campaign group The Parenthood and joins us now. Good morning, Georgie.
Good morning.
Well, it couldn't last forever, could it?
No, it couldn't, but it is very disappointing that the government have chosen to snap back so early on this package. When the government announced that there would be a fee-free period for early childhood education and care, they indicated that it would be in place for 6 months, and they have now, the Education Minister yesterday has said that the package will end on the 12th of July. Childcare workers will no longer be eligible for JobKeeper, which is a pretty curious development given just 2 days ago the Prime Minister guaranteed that that subsidy would be in place until September.
Well, the government said it's done this because demand levels are back to pre-pandemic times.
Well, that's actually not true. So yesterday, the Education Minister, Dan Tehan, did keep saying that demand has returned. Now, on closer inspection, what he was saying is centres are currently now at 74% of pre-COVID occupancy. So another way of putting that is that there's still 26% less demand now than there was before the pandemic hit, and that was without fees being charged. Now, we know very clearly that roughly 44% of households who use early childhood education and care have lost employment or jobs, employment or income. And we know that up to a third of families who use these services said when fees return, they will not be able to afford to keep their kids in the same way they were before. So it is a bit of a misnomer to pretend that we are at pre-pandemic levels of demand. We're not. It's at 74% occupancy rates, and that's while it was free. So it's not rational to consider that that would translate to 74% of attendance rates when fees return.
So what do you think is going to happen in 4 weeks' time when this scheme ends?
Well, if parents do what they've said they're going to do, it means they'll have to pull their children out. And what we know is services cannot operate viably with occupancy rates below 70%. That's below break-even point. So even if every child who's been enrolled stayed there now while it's free, it's still very difficult for services to operate. Now, the government have introduced a transition package to help services through, which is welcome, because a lot of services have been pushed to the brink because of the arrangement that's been in place. But what is going to be very difficult is if all these families withdraw their children, the rescue package, the interim arrangement will not be enough to sustain services and keep their doors open. And what that means is we've then got children who will miss out on all of the proven benefits of early childhood education and care, but it's also going to make it more difficult for families to return to work if and when they can find a job. Because what happens is if these services close their doors, it means in 6 months' time, if we have a great recovery and there are jobs available, parents, if they cannot find appropriate, adequate care for their children, they will not be able to take those jobs.
OK, and we'll put those concerns to the Education Minister when you're having them on the show shortly. Thanks, Georgie.
Thanks, Ali.
In a major blow for parents, the federal government's free childcare scheme comes to an end in about 4 weeks' time. And as a working mum with two young kids in childcare, this is a tough one because I've been lucky enough to keep my job throughout this pandemic, but plenty of mum mates have either lost theirs or had their working hours cut. So this decision is going to have a huge impact on them. The Education Minister, Dan Tehan, joins me now from Parliament House. Minister, thank you so much for your time. I think we all understand free childcare can't last forever, but will the economy be better by July 12 and will jobs be back as normal?
Well, what we're seeing is extra demand come into the childcare system. The latest survey that the government undertook showed that demand was back up at levels of 74%. So the decision we've had to balance is, do we keep the current system in place, which was beginning to limit the amount of hours that parents could get their children into care, or do we put a transition arrangement in place which enables more parents to be able to get their children into care? Now, we said we would give parents and the sector 4 weeks' notice of a change. We've done that, and we think through the consultations we've undertaken with the sector that this will get the balance right and we'll be able to see more children get the care they need over the coming months.
OK, so we had the advocacy group of the Parenthood on the show earlier, and they said that demand is as high as it is at the moment because childcare is free, and that some families, they will have to cut back days or withdraw their kids from care entirely. I mean, that means someone then has to stay home to care for the kids, and it's typically the mum. How does that help an economy already in recession?
So that's one of the things that we thought long and hard about. And through discussions with the sector, we agreed to make changes to the activity test, which will free up parents' ability to be able to get access to subsidised care. Now, we have to remember 20% of families in centre-based daycare pay no more than $2 an hour for care, and for 70% of families, it's $5 an hour or less. So the scheme that we're bringing back, the childcare subsidy scheme, is targeted for those who are least well off. And so we think with the changes to the activity test and the fact that the scheme, the old scheme that we're bringing back, is targeted for those who have lost work or have seen reduced hours, that they will get more subsidy as a result. We think that we've got the balance right in this transition.
But, I mean, that old system that you're talking about that you revert to, I mean, that's a system that's broken, isn't it? I mean, childcare costs, they were crippling before the pandemic hit. We've got some of the highest fees in the world.
Well, what the OECD shows is that the government invests into the childcare sector. We're the fifth highest nation in terms of investment into our childcare sector. The new system that we'd put in place, which will have been in operation for 2 years as of July 1 this year, has seen out-of-pocket expenses come down for parents by 4%, the latest data we've had from the ABS, and it is targeted for those who earn least. So, what as I've said before, for 20% of families, they pay no more than $2 an hour in centre-based daycare.
The issue is that parents still have to pay the gap between the subsidy and the cost of care, and we know in pretty much every major city that gap is quite substantial.
So that gap obviously varies, and it depends on your income. As I've said, the new system, which we put in place nearly 2 years ago, has seen that gap come down by 4%, and we want to continue working with the sector to make sure that childcare remains affordable going forward. But the most important thing is that we've got a sector to be able to do that with. And can I thank the sector for what they've done over the last 2 months? Because working with the government, we've got 99% of our providers up, running and operating. If you look internationally, the coronavirus pandemic has had a huge impact on the sector. But our sector has worked with the government and I think is in a strong position now as we open the economy to transition to more normality.
OK, well, will you agree to at least review it if, as these advocacy groups say, and as parents are saying, that they're going to have to pull their kids out or reduce the number of days? If you see that happen, once the scheme ends, will you review it?
Well, this isn't a set and forget. As we did with a relief package that we put in place, we said we would continue to work with the sector and continue to consult with the sector. And that relief package worked as a result. So we will continue to consult and work with the sector through these transition arrangements that we've now put in place.
I'll tell you what, it is a tough one because we know that, you know, the money's got to be paid back. There is no bottomless pit, but this is going to have a big impact and mostly on working mums. So hopefully we do get it right. Thanks, Minister. Appreciate it.
A pleasure to be with you.